Self-driving cars represent both the biggest possibilities and the huge risks the combination of tech and cars poses. Right now, most self-driving cars have limited autonomous capabilities or so-called partial automation. For example, Tesla cars offer the autopilot feature. It's a great help when you're driving on the highway. Autopilot can keep your car moving in its lane and match the speed of other vehicles around you. But when the autopilot is on, you still need to pay full attention. You have to be alert and engaged. Tesla's manual instructs drivers to never take your hands off the wheel when using autopilot. Actual self-driving cars are already on the road, even if in limited numbers and controlled areas. For example, Waymo, Google's self-driving car division, recently launched driverless taxis in Phoenix suburbs. The area is limited because the cars need a detailed three-dimensional map to drive around safely, or at all. What's more, the suburbs in Phoenix aren't as crowded with people, vehicles, and other obstacles as the city itself or a lot of other metropolitan areas. It's a much easier territory for self-driving cars to navigate. In any case, it's an exciting step towards fully autonomous cars. Self-driving cars are outfitted with cameras and sensors. Their AI uses the controlled data to build a picture of where the car is, where it's going, where the other vehicles, pedestrians, or obstacles are. The road is tricky. A self-driving car may encounter a rare but dangerous event, and the car's AI needs to know how to react. So the AI needs a lot of data. A lot. Tens, maybe hundreds of millions of miles driven and observed. Let's hope that the breakthrough comes as soon as possible, because the opportunities created by self-driving cars are awesome. Not all people, for example, the elderly or people with disabilities, can drive cars or afford to buy them. And the COVID-19 pandemic has shown that there are circumstances when you simply cannot use a taxi or public transport. Self-driving cars can provide better, safer, and more comfortable options to get from one place to another. Why buy a car when you can hail a cheap and safe auto taxi? Not to mention that a lot of car accidents happen due to human error. A well-trained AI behind the wheel may save countless lives. Yes, there's a theoretical possibility of hacking an autonomous car and causing mayhem on the streets and sidewalks. Manufacturers are taking this issue very seriously, but you can never be sure with cybersecurity. Manufacturers have to find all possible vulnerabilities and fix them. A hacker has to find only one vulnerability to exploit it. But the pros are so much better than the cons. Imagine a world filled with self-driving cars. It would be transformative, especially in logistics. Self-driving cars need no sleep nor rest. They could drive 24/7 to their destinations. A mini car, four wheels and a cargo space, could deliver your package within minutes from ordering it. We could all have self-driving cars, or we could share them, or both. It would save money and parking space. And these cars could potentially be much safer than human-driven ones. Fewer accidents, many human lives saved. But what do you think? Do the benefits of self-driving cars outweigh the risks? Tell us in the comments.